Hi everybody, and welcome back to another week of Kids Continued. I'm so excited that you were able to join us this morning. And today we are continuing in our series of objects or activities that we see that link in with the Bible story or with something that we learn from our Bible. Okay, so today we are actually going to be talking about our image. You know, this image that you have, and I'm pretty sure all of you have seen pictures of yourself or even a mirror. I have a little mirror here. Okay, when you look into a mirror, it reflects an image. Now, the image we portray, the image that we show to other people, that is what we are going to be chatting about today. I'm sure you guys know this, but if you didn't, let me tell you that we, people, humans, were mentioned at the very beginning of the Bible, okay? We are spoken about when God created man. And when he created man, he said he will create man in our image, in the image of God. Now, sometimes that can be a bit confusing because we think, does that mean God looks like this? We're not sure. But we know that Jesus looked like a man. He looked like us. He had eyes and ears and hair and fingers and feet and arms and legs and all those things. So Jesus came as a man. But another way that we show the image of God is in our character and how we reflect and how we show people the way that we live our lives. Now, when we look into a mirror, do you see exactly what you are showing, or does it look a little distorted? Now, I'm talking about a mirror like you have in your house. I'm pretty sure you have one in your bathroom, or your mom's got one in her dressing room at her dressing table. And I know you sometimes get mirrors when you go to a circus or somewhere, a amusement park, that have all these funny shapes, so they make you look a little weird. But I'm just talking about a little mirror, like I have here, that reflects back exactly what you see. Now, we are called to reflect the image of God. We are made to be in his image, and we need to show that to people around us. Now, there is a passage in 2 Corinthians chapter 3, and it speaks about how we live in a new covenant, and in that, we are called to reflect the image of God. And the more we grow closer to God, and the more we allow his Holy Spirit to work in us, the more we reflect God to other people. Now, let me explain the new covenant. That may be a bit confusing, but it's actually not, because you know the story. The new covenant that we live under is the one that was made when Jesus died on the cross to save us from our sins. He took the punishment for our sin, and he bared that weight so that we could be saved when we trust and hope and believe in Jesus and what he did for us. So that is the new covenant. And when we live under God's law and we have accepted Jesus as our Lord and Savior, we need to show his image to people around us. And you know this. You've heard it at Sunday school or from your moms and dads or grands and grandpas. I'm sure you have heard this before, that you need to show the love of God to all the people around you. But how can we do that? How do you show God's love? And I don't even mean about talking about it. How do you show God's love? So for me, I think one of the easiest things to do to show God's love is to remember that God is in that person too. So how would you treat that person? How would you treat God? Would you show them kindness and be friendly and show love to them so you help look after people? Or would you ignore them and have a bad attitude and speak to them with unkind words? I don't think so. So we need to show and reflect Christ in our life. Something very important to remember is that if we want to reflect Christ in our life and we want to portray the image of him, we need to know who he is. So we need to be reading our Bible and going to church and learning all that we can about God. Because the more we know about him, the more we are able to understand his word and be able to share that with other people. So, in this coming week, have a look at all the ways that you are reflecting God. Or maybe there are some ways where you feel, I need to actually work on that. I I need to work at the way I speak to people or who I interact with and things like that. I hope you guys have a great week, and it seems to be warming up, so hopefully we can go have a swim pretty soon and they don't have too many cold days ahead of us. Have a wonderful week, guys. Bye.